But yeah, a 1 gigabyte memory stick, that's gonna be perfect. Cause there's a... Here's a funny thing. Apparently the PSP did not have very good network infrastructure, or, you know, wireless network built in or something, whatever you wanna call it. It wasn't good. And my router is so new, I can't change the security setting on it. It is set to the current best security setting. At least I believe it's the current best. And my PSP won't connect to it. Heck, I even tried to tether it to my phone and it wouldn't connect. Because my phone is apparently on the most modern. So, I can't connect my PSP to the internet. Which means no online gaming. That's assuming some of them even still work. I don't know if they still have the servers online for any of the games. Speaking of which, I want to get Need for Speed Most Wanted on it again. Or one of them. I think one of them had an open world. It might have been Carbon. I'll have to look that up, because whatever Need for Speed has an open world, I want it. And then, what else was there? Well, yeah, back to the internet connectivity. Since I can't connect it to the internet, this guy left it on a really low firmware. He probably hasn't touched it in years. It's on 3.6. Just for perspective, 3.6 didn't even have, like, the PlayStation Network added to the firmware yet. And the most recent firmware is actually 6.61, I think? Because they don't make firmware for it anymore, right? So that's it. Which means... I'm not going to do custom firmware, so you don't have to suggest that. I don't like hacking things. I like them to just be stock. And I know I could probably turn it for a profit just to get it, because the guy didn't sell it very expensive, but whatever. I'm not doing that. I'm not shady. So, I have to download the update on the computer, transfer it to it via USB, because I don't have an adapter. And then I have to update it, but I can't update it without a battery, so I have to wait until I get that battery. Which really stinks. It, like, really stinks. So, once I update it, I still can't connect it to the internet, at least as far as I know. I don't think they did a firmware thing that would suddenly make it work, but hey, if they did, that'd be amazing. But that means all the games I'll be playing are going to be offline games. And I can't download games. I mean, I probably could if I downloaded them on the PlayStation 3. You know, download them on the PS3 and then transfer them. I didn't think of that, actually. But I don't want to do download a game, so a 1 gigabyte memory stick is going to be perfect. Because I'll just get UMD games for really cheap. And then I'll just be able to play them like that. Because save data for the PSP did not use up a lot. Oh! I want to get the Untold Legends games again. Those were fun, little dungeon crawlers. See, there's so many games I want to buy again. But look at me, I'm over here playing Splatoon and just talking about PSP. How does that work? We have pretty much the same strategy every time. I just follow the carbon. Oh, you know, I got especially lucky that I wanted to buy a silver slim PSP. Because of all the PSPs I owned, and yes, I was that bad, I actually owned all of them, except for that weird one they released in Europe, the E model, whatever it was, that only had, like, mono speaker, and I think no Wi-Fi. I don't think it had Wi-Fi at all. So it was a really weird one. I don't even think it had a UMD drive, actually. I think it was... Did it? Maybe it did, I don't know. But... Of all the ones I owned, I had a silver slim, and I loved it the most. I considered buying an original one again, since that was the first one I had. I got it at launch. But it's just so big and heavy and not very convenient to carry around. And I want this thing to be something I can, like, take to work with me if I get bored or something, you know? Because that does happen. I get bored at work. Sometimes I have sit-down time and I get bored. And it'd be better to play a little quick PSP game that I can take in and out of sleep mode real fast than, you know, killing my phone battery, browsing Reddit or Twitter or something. Oh crap, I am so dead. By my own hand. I thought there was a little ledge behind that thing, that's why I jumped, but it was all for naught. But yeah, the PSP I got, I actually got the white Vader model. So that's neat. Did that guy just fall and die? I don't know. I always thought the white Vader model looked cool, but I never wanted to pay the money for it. And then this guy ends up selling one that's in great condition for like 50 bucks. Great condition, low firmware. This is the kind of thing a hacker would want to buy, probably, you know? And it really is in good shape. Like, the screen hardly has any scratches on it. The only thing that's really scratched up is the metal ring on the back. I could probably replace that. But enough about the PSP. Let's get back into the game, huh? And like, I could probably fit in two more matches before I have to stop recording. So now I don't know what to talk about. I know what to talk about. Zelda, Link Between Worlds. Apparently, Nintendo issued a challenge on Twitter to beat the whole game with only 3 hearts. Thank God they didn't say to do it on Hero Mode. So I've been playing that, which is actually a very big distraction. And I got through the first 3 dungeons, no problem. Then once I got to the Dark World, that's when I started dying a lot. Kind of sucks. Or not... It's not the Dark World. What am I... I'm thinking of Link to the Past. Link Between Worlds, it's low rule. So I got to low rule and I've been dying a lot. So it's actually going to be a hard challenge, but I'm almost ready to go into the first dungeon in the Dark World. We'll see how that goes. But it's nice having a reason to pick the game up again. I haven't played it since it came out because I beat it 2 days after it came out. I pretty much played it like nonstop, 100% completed it. I think that was when I wasn't yet doing YouTube stuff, so I had more free time on my hands. I was only an off and on streamer. Speaking of which, shoot, I think today, the day that I'm recording, I think this is my anniversary of being a streamer. If not today, it's probably tomorrow, actually. I think today's the 26th. Oh, you little jumper, you. Oh, whoa, whoa. Is that really good Hydra player still in here? Dang it. I knew I should have used my bubble. Aww. I knew I should have used it. Oh, is that him on my team? Do I have the Hydra? Yeah, none of that bomb crap. I ain't having it. course, you did already get, like, most of them off, I think. It's nice seeing a good variety of weapons in Turf War, at least. Be a camper. I'm not gonna go on a camping trip. Sorry, guys. Nice. You know, that might have actually been the last one I had time for. So I'm actually gonna stop after this one. Yeah, 2-1. I guess I did okay. There could have been worse ways to end a video off, am I right? So we will just back out of there kindly. So, you know, I kind of want to apologize for earlier. I don't, you know, like way back in the first video of this recording. I didn't mean to be so salty. I don't know what's up with me lately. I've been easily getting frustrated at things. And I don't know why. I don't know what my deal is. Maybe it is stress. It probably is stress, but you know, I was getting pissed at the strength up user and the camping and stuff. The camping, okay, that's one thing, but to use strength up, that's a silly thing to get pissed at. So, I was just salty because I've been upset or something. Stress. You know how it is probably. I'm sure we all feel stress. So, with that being said, I really do hope you enjoyed the videos, guys. Thank you so much for watching, as always. I kind of said that out of order. Crap. See, now I'm all... I confused myself now. As always, do whatever you want, and I will see you next time. Later, guys. Oh, that's right, they have a disruptor. Oh, Jesus, no! You stupid stealth-jumping dynamos! I would have been dead if they didn't nerf them.